If you said, like, does any, how many people even know 99 agencies? I'd say most, I'd say practically no one knows the names of 99 agencies, let alone the 420 or whatever there are. Yeah, so we have to unwind the situation. And I think, we're going to do it, and it's going to unleash a new era of prosperity, because people don't even realize how much they're getting held back by millions of federal regulations. Millions, literally. So. And if it turns out that we accidentally got rid of a good regulation, we'll just put it back. It's that easy.
Hey, Elon. I'm Dan from Pennsylvania as well. I am a teacher, public school teacher, and I just bought a Tesla this year, and it's been amazing for my 1 hour commute.
Great.
So thank you about that.
Cool.
Additionally,
self-driving?
Yes. Oh my gosh.
Pretty cool.
It blows. Like when I go into the teacher parking lot, and I just tried the summon today.
Yeah.
Like, yeah. Everybody's jaws hit the floor. Yeah.
It's wild.
Yeah. So Republicans need to get out the vote. And as the mail-in balloting becomes more common, what can I tell my friends about the safety and security of mail-in ballots?
Yeah.
This election and future elections? And then real quick also.
Sure.
My daughter is two. Her name is Isabella. She loves the planets and loves astronomy already. And I want to know what I can, as a teacher, do to help inspire her curiosity for the heavens, the stars.
Sure. With respect to voting integrity, I think probably the best thing to do is to hand it in person. But you can also mail it in, and you can check to see whether your ballot has been received. So it is possible to check online or in person to see if your ballot has been received. But I would encourage people to vote early, because what can happen is that, you know, November 5th comes around, and there's like, you got something critical at work, or there's like a family emergency, or, you know, this, yeah, some mysterious cybersecurity event that you never know might happen. So, you know, anything can crop up on November 5th, whether it's personal or some, you know, there could be some other issue. So it is best to vote early. Now, it is very encouraging to see the early vote numbers, because if you compare the early vote numbers this year to 2020, there's about I think the last numbers I saw, it's like a 200,000 to 300,000 voter difference from 2020. That's major. Because I think it was like an 80,000 vote threshold last time. So Biden won-ish by 80,000 votes. That was the number that was reported. But the interesting thing is that the delta for early votes is now 200, I think, maybe approaching 250 or even 300,000 better than 2020, which is far in excess of the margin of of 2020. So Pennsylvania is trending in the right direction. It's very encouraging. But there's still a lot of work to do, and we don't want to be complacent. So definitely get everyone you know to vote. And as I mentioned earlier, people can actually go in person on Monday and Tuesday if they're concerned about putting anything in the mail. And they can actually get their ballot. Like, even if they don't have their ballot, they can literally go to the county office, get the ballot, even though it says absentee, and then hand it in, even though you're not absent. It's weird. But it works. But it stops working on Wednesday, and then the next opportunity is November 5th. So it's kind of quirky, but those are the current rules. And then, let's see, with respect to your daughter, I think in order to inspire, like, kids are inspired by real, amazing imagery. Like they see something amazing. They see a rocket taking off, a rocket landing, or you know, robots walking around, or like cool things, like the stuff that you see in sci-fi movies. And when they see stuff like that, they're inspired automatically. They're inspired because it's because there are real advancements in technology, and that's you know that's what inspires kids because it should. You know, like kids are like a great filter for what's awesome. Like you can tell like if a little kid reacts like, wow, that's amazing, and that's like that's real, you know. So like kids love the Cybertruck, they love rockets, you know. And that's because and they have no filter. They just say what they immediately say what they think, you know. So so great new rocket technology that allows us to, like I said, go there and have a permanent science station on the moon. You know, not just like it's great that we went to the moon, you know, 50 plus years ago, but we want to go to the moon and actually have a science base. Like we've got a science base in Antarctica. Well, we should have a science base on the moon, and we should be building a city on Mars. And I actually think it's the long-term future of civilization. I think. Could be decided by whether or not we build a self-sustaining city on Mars. And if we do, that is a city that would have millions of people, and it would be like if anybody wants to go to Mars, they could. And that would be an incredibly exciting, inspiring thing to aspire to go to Mars. Be like, wow, let's make that real.
Let's bring her to Mars.
Yes, let's bring her to Mars. Yeah, if she thinks like, wow, one day I could go to Mars, you know. And be one of the Martians, and that would be super awesome, I think. You know, it's wild. You go. It takes 6 months actually when you go from Earth to Mars. You're just traveling across this void of nothingness for hundreds of millions of miles until eventually you reach another planet. It's kind of incredible to think that that's even possible. But and how amazing would that be? You know, be like, wow. I think that we want to have a future where life is multiplanetary, where we're advancing rocket technology, and like I said, where Star Trek Starfleet Academy is real. And that's what will inspire your daughter.
Thank you.
All right.
Hi, Elon. My name is Lauren from Pennsylvania. Thank you for being here. Thank you for everything you're doing, and congratulations with SpaceX. You and your whole team are absolutely brilliant. I have two specific questions for you, but I was curious because I looked all over on X today, and I didn't see anybody who won the $1 million prize.
Oh, yes.
Was that given out today?
Well, let's see. We are going to give it out tonight, in fact. So let's... Should we go ahead and do it? Yeah. Okay, let's do it. Good timing. All right. Judy Kimura.
Wow!
Yeah. Judy has no idea, by the way. She's just learning now. So. So I think Judy's on her way here. Like I said, Judy had not learned when you learned. All right. Oh, thank you. All right. Woo-hoo. I mean, we're trying to get attention for this very important petition to support the Constitution, and it's like if we need the right to free speech, we need the right to bear arms. Otherwise, there is no right to free speech. And it's people sort of wonder why what's up with the $1 million prizes? I'm like. Well, we needed to get the legacy media to talk about it. And I just knew that they would be like complaining like hell.
about it.
That, like, for sure, complaining on every newspaper and every TV station are complaining like crazy. And I was like, great, that's going to get the word out. Most welcome.
All right. Can you say hi to my son, Caden?
Yes. Hi, Caden and Kaylee. Hi. All right. So we're going to be giving out $1 million every day through November 5th. And all you have to do is sign the petition in support of the First and Second Amendment. That's it. You don't even have to vote. It would be nice if you voted, but you don't have to. And that, to support basically sign something you already believe in, and you get a chance to win $1 million every day from now through the election. Yeah.
Congratulations, Judy. Let me know if you want to share. Two specific questions for you, Elon. One regarding your concern about the declining birth rate.
Yeah, it's a big deal.
It is. Besides us as women having more and more children, and since we're the only ones who can give birth,
yes.
What would you...
I mean, you do need a womb. Without it, you need a womb is necessary, otherwise you can't have kids currently.
It is necessary.
Yes.
What would be your solution? Would you be in favor of creating or supporting an IVF surrogacy program to increase the birth rates? And my second question is about what would you recommend towards the first steps on improving our American educational system? Thank you.
Yeah, I mean, in general, like, I think we should really view the birth rate as like a extremely fundamental crisis. It's really shocking how low it is. The birth rate in America, in the United States, has been below replacement rate since I was born, roughly around 1971 or so. That's since then, America has been below replacement rate. And pretty much every country, it seems as soon as they reach a certain level of prosperity, the birth rate drops below replacement. And then I started looking into, well, has this happened before in history? And in fact, it has. It's in basically every civilization in the past. It's maybe counterintuitive, but the more prosperous that a civilization becomes, the lower the birth rate. So it's because you think, well, with prosperity you'd have more resources, then you'd have more kids. Actually, no. The historical fact is that the longer that a civilization has been prosperous, the worse its birth rate got. This was an issue even in ancient Rome, like in 50 BC. There's like, actually, we still have like the Roman laws that were written. They passed laws to try to improve the birth rate of Roman citizens in 50 BC. Basically, this is a fundamental civilizational challenge that has been encountered many times before. It's not something that just, you know, happened recently. It's occurred throughout the cycle of civilizations. I hope we can at least partly reverse it. And I think part of that is at least bringing it to conscious awareness. Because I meet many people who think that there are too many humans on Earth, that this is not true.